Welcome to another test and teardown video. This time it's another Goerz Metrawatt Unigor, but this one is called 3S and the type number is 226213. So what is so special or different about this one compared to the other one we just played with? Well, for starters, it got this AC, or then the resistance or capacitor, or then the DC switch. This is kind of back again. If we look at the previous version, the 4P. So the 4P don't have this switch. So all those ranges over here, there will be DC ranges and there will be AC ranges. So that costs a lot of switch positions, right? So let's look at this one again. Now, all the voltage positions, you have the options of AC and DC. So of course, that is the difference. Still got the same ranges in resistance, and you got two ranges of capacitance, and here is a lot of things, or at least one thing that is different. Look at that. So that is the AC and DC modes, and 5000 volt mode is also selectable. See, if you look at this one, the 5 kilovolt was only DC mode. And of course, there's a big difference when it comes to the design. If we just take a very fast look at this, this is DC mode only, so all this high voltage is just going through a resistor. Okay, so what if we have 5000 volts going through a voltage divider? Oh, it must handle both AC and DC. So now you already know what I'm talking about, right? What is the difference? Okay, let's just take the first super sneak peek. They're very, very different. So the resistor for the high voltage is put inside a metal shield, and that shield generates a capacitive coupling to the resistor element, and by moving this back and forward you can calibrate the capacitive compensation and this way get a linear voltage divider. And they even put in all sorts of grease and stuff here. I cleaned a lot of this away because it was super full of snesky. All sorts of, yeah, you can see it a little bit here. Still, but all this green puke was just all over the place. So that is, of course, a big difference in the design. It is a little bit special. Oh yeah, this is still the same. They're reusing exactly this design with the overcurrent load, poing, and then there's this button to reset it. Really, really a smart feature for overload protection. What else are they doing in this model? The capacitance input got two different ranges, as you can see here. Microfarad times 0.1 or picofarad times 100. So how are they doing that? And again, like previous versions, like the 4P we just talked about. So the 4P only got one range, and there's only one way to connect the capacitor, And so that is the readout. But let's look at the 3S. So this is the 3S. I'm so sorry. The backside of the 3S is looking like it's a lot older. So the contrast here is really, really bad. And yeah, this is the German version, so I'm so sorry about that. But I'm sure you get the point. So the difference here in the two different ranges, that is how it is connected. So mains is connected here and here, and then the capacitor is to that point. But look at that. In the picofarad times 100, you go straight into the ohm setting, right? Isn't that just fantastic? You're just putting in AC. So the switch, of course, it will add a diode rectifier and so such, right? Also, it's the common thing about those instruments. Again, let's compare. Here is a 4P and the 3S. It's just different, you know, how everything is connected. This is, oops, sorry about that. See? Why is it always different from all the different version? Now this, now that, This is must be very, very confusing for customers with multiple of these instruments. And it is, can you imagine using this instrument and this is the backside? You don't have access to this at the same time as you're looking at the front and when you're dialing this and you're connecting this and you're reading out this. No, no, no. You need to swap it around, read the manual. Oh, yeah, okay, now I can remember. Okay, good. And then do your thing. Huh. Okay, so I'm a little bit angry about it's different. I don't care how it is, but I just want it to be the same on all the different versions anyway. So what we need to do now is play a little bit with this instrument and see if it is just as accurate. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. There was one more thing I forgot to show you guys. The input impedance. See, that was the 4P. Very, very high input impedance. And this is the 3S. Very, very low, or, well, I wouldn't call it low. It's not that bad, but it's a lot less. And of course, this is why it is able to do AC. You need to be able to win over all the capacity in all the different voltage and resistors and whatnot. So that is a good trick to solve that problem. So this is the 3S again, and we're playing a little bit with the voltage accuracy and the different voltage ranges. I've been playing a little bit with this now, and this is by far the most accurate range. Here is the 100 millivolts, and at the moment I am inputting 60 millivolts. So that is just spot on, and all is fantastic. But I'm sad to say, in all the other ranges, it's just not accurate. Let me turn off the light there. So this is, again, 100 millivolts in the 500 millivolt range. No, I'm 60. That was 60, right? Okay. So that was 100. See, again, it shows a little bit too much. 200. A little bit again, too much. 300, it's almost there, right? 400, and this is not the worst. Let's go to 2.5 volts. Let's give it a half. So where are we? 2.5 is that one. So that is the 0.5. So let's give it 1. It's a little bit too high, and let's give it 2. Here we go. That's a little bit too, okay. Compared to a lot of other analog instruments, this is of course not bad. But compared to all the other of the same brand and type and all the different, this is just another version of them. This one is not winning on all things to the last tenths of a micrometer that I'm just saying. But it's, of course, it's super, super nice and all that, but it's, the other models are just better. 5 volts, and we are in the, yeah, we are 10 volts, so that's 10 volts. And 5, and yeah, I can clearly see the error, and I'm not used to that with this brand. Well, that's just what I'm saying. And of course, we need to play with the higher voltage ranges. So this is 1,000 volts. So that will be that range, and now I need to be careful not to touch anything. And see, now it's showing too low. Really? So that was 5, 6, 7. Wee! Look at that, that's a lot. This was supposed to be on the 800, and this is 900, that's a lot of, and that is 1,000. So that should be 1,000. Look at that, way too low, oh no! So that's why I'm saying 1,000, because I am giving you 1,000. I better turn this off. Ooh. I'm not going to play so much more with this. I've been through all the different ranges and all the different things. And I'm really, really happy about it. It's, so this is, what is it, 5 amp, and I will give it 3 amps. And I think this is spot on, isn't it? And stop doing all this annoying noise. Maybe we could just give it 1 amp. And then, okay, let's first see how 1 amp look in this range. So that was a 5. Okay, this is also okay. And then, doing. Oh, that is showing quite a lot too much. Is my zero is spot on. So I think maybe this is just this one. I'm not saying this is all 3S. That is a little bit, you know, a fast Monday calibration maybe. Anyway, thank you for watching. And if, oh yeah, if you want more super duper details about how everything works, you can see all the other model numbers. I just wanted this video to be really, really fast and only cover the difference that I actually found in this one, and that was this resistor made for AC. Everything else in this one is just exactly as we have seen before. So no need to make a long video and bore you to death with all the stuff repeated. Let's save the megabytes on the internet. That is what we do, yeah. Exactly the same resistor values here. No, not exactly, right? Let's give it a little bit of light is here. So that one. No, they're a little bit different. Shielded cables and all. That is nice.